Welcome to a lesson on subtracting whole numbers. So here's a pretty straightforward subtraction problem involving two whole numbers. Here we have 5 minus 2 equals 3. So to model this, if we have 5 items and we subtract 2 or take away 2 of them, we're left with 1, 2, 3 items. So 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. So subtracting whole numbers is the opposite of adding whole numbers. The minuend is the starting number or the number in which another number is being subtracted. So in this case, the minuend is 5. The subtrahend is a number that is being subtracted. So in this example, the subtrahend is 2. And the difference is the result or the answer of the subtraction. So our difference is 3. So in order to subtract whole numbers, we'll write the difference in vertical form and line up the corresponding place values, just as we did when we were adding whole numbers. And then we'll subtract by starting with the ones column, working our way left. However, if the column does not have a large enough number to subtract, we will have to borrow from the column on the left. Let's take a look at an example. 489 minus 37. So when we write 37, we'll put the 3 under the 8 in the tens column and the 7 under the 9 for the ones column. And now we'll subtract starting on the right, working our way left. 9 minus 7, that would be 2. 8 minus 3, that would be 5. And then we have the 4 in the hundreds column. So our difference is 452. So 489 minus 37 is equal to 452. Let's look at some more examples. Here we have 873 minus 58. Let's write it in vertical form. Now when we start in the ones column, we have 3 minus 8. We can't take away 8 from 3 using whole numbers. So what that means is we have to borrow from this 7. If we borrow 1 from the 7, this would be 6. But if we borrow 1 from the tens column, we're really borrowing 10. So if we add the 10 to the 3, this becomes 13. And it's customary to just write a 1 right here and view this as 13 now. So we would have 13 minus 8, which would give us 5. And then we have 6 minus 5 in the tens column, that would be 1. And then we still have this 8 in the hundreds column. So 873 minus 58 is equal to 815. Now I do want to take a moment and show this borrowing again using this place value chart. If we write 873 in this table, this 3 here means 3 ones, this 7 here means 7 tens, and this 8 here means 8 hundreds. So notice in this problem we borrowed 1 from the tens column. So if we're borrowing 1 from the 7, this changes to a 6, but we're really borrowing 10. So the ones column becomes 10 plus 3, or 13, as we showed using this notation here. Let's go and take a look at a few more examples. 14,389 minus 6,846. Everything's lined up properly. Let's go ahead and start to subtract, starting on the right and working our way left. 9 minus 6, that would be 3. 8 minus 4 would be 4. Now the next column we have 3 minus 8. We can't take away 8 from 3, so we have to borrow from the 4. So we change the 4 to a 3 and then add 10 to the 3, which would give us 13. So now for this column we have 13 minus 8, that's 5. And notice here we have 3 minus 6, again we have to borrow. So we'll change the 1 to a 0, add 10 to the 3, so we have 13 minus 6, that would give us 7. So our difference is 7,543. Let's try another. 7,004,585 minus 86,942. Let's write this in vertical form. And start subtracting from the ones column. 5 minus 2, that would give us 3. 8 minus 4, that would be 4. Now notice in the hundreds column we have 5 minus 9. We can't take away 9 from 5, so we have to borrow. But notice on this example the next column is 0. So in this case we're supposed to go to the next column, which is also 0. So we're supposed to go to the next column, which is also 0. So finally we get to the 7 and we have to borrow from this 7. So we change the 7 to a 6. Normally we would add 10 to this column, but remember we have to borrow to eventually add to this 5. So instead of making this a 10, we'll make this a 9, add 10 to this column, but instead of adding 10, we'll make it 9, add 10 to this column, but we still have to borrow from this column, so we'll make this 9, and then finally add 10 to this 5 to get 15. So when we're trying to borrow, if the column to the left is 0, we have to keep moving to the left until we find a column that's not 0. So now we can subtract. 15 minus 9 would be 6. This column is now 9. 9 minus 6 would be 3. Next column is 9 minus 8. That would be 1. This column is just 9, and this column is just 6. So our difference is 6,913,643. Let's take a look at a word problem. You have $1,284 in your checking account. If you write a check for a car repair for $529, and then write another check to your landlord for $450, what is your ending balance? So we start with the beginning balance, $1,284. We have to subtract the first check of $529. This will give us the balance after the first check clears. Notice in the first column we can't subtract 9 from 4, so we have to borrow from the 8. So we change this to 7 and add 10 to the ones column, so this is now 14. 14 minus 9 would be 5. The next column is 7 minus 2, that would be 5. In the next column we have 2 minus 5. Normally we would borrow, but since this is the last column to subtract, we can go ahead and just take 12 and subtract 5 to get 7. That would be the same thing as changing this to a 0 and adding 10 to the 2 to get 12. So after the first check clears, we have $755 in our account, but now we have to subtract the second check of $450. So we'll have 755 minus 450. And this will give us the ending balance once the check's clear. So 5 minus 0, that would be 5. 5 minus 5, that would be 0. And then 7 minus 4, that would be 3. So the new balance of the account will be $305 after those two checks clear. That's going to do it for this video. Thank you for watching.